Welcome back. Maria is here. She has some tips for giving our wedding card envelopes the extra special touch. And I mean, with this special touch, she is pushing the envelope when it comes to designs.
Right? I am pushing the envelope. I got that
you
this
got
time.
That? You
got that? I got that this time.
She's literally pushing the envelope.
Pushing the envelope, literally. Yeah, well, for wedding season, as a guest, you're always, you know, trying so hard to make the gift for the couple extra special, and you spend so much time picking out the right card and the right gift.
Yeah.
So why not make it extra special? Go that little extra step and make your stand out with a little DIY on the outside to give a sneak peek of what the beautiful card is on the inside. And we have, of course, our Hallmark cards over here that were the inspiration for decorating the envelopes for the outside of the cards. And so it gives them a little sneak peek.
Well, it's one of the tips, or your first tip, is actually inspired by the font?
The font, exactly. So you can see in this top card we have over here, I love this font. It's just fun and unique and interesting.
Right.
And I also love kind of finding fonts in the cards that resemble what the couple kind of is. So someone who's modern and kind of fun.
Oh, yeah.
And that's what I see in this. And so for the actual envelope, you can just take a marker and you can draw the, you know, Mr. and Mrs. and then take a silver gel pen and do that fun detailing.
Oh, I love
that. So you can just do that.
It looks like it came that way.
Exactly.
It's beautiful.
And it's your eye instantly goes to that.
It's
and
like
it's,
a
it
set.
Makes it stand out. So the happily ever after card you can see there with the little blue swirls.
Yeah.
What you can actually do is take the envelope, put it over it, and trace. So then you have the exact one that, so
oh,
now
smart.
They really do look married.
Yes, they
and
do.
They can be together like that. And you know what, the yellow one over there with the detailing of the sort of silver, you can use a pencil to do the same type of thing, and it reminds me of Paige, the sort of like rustic chic type of look. Doesn't that like I thought of that when I saw that one. And then this top one over here looks three-dimensional, that we have yes to love. And to make it three-dimensional on the card, all you need to do is actually punch out the same type of look for that and glue it on, and then you have a three-dimensional card to make
that's
sort of three-dimensional look
of
the.
Which is my
favorite. Ask me to make your favorite child.
I know.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. I think I love the first one. I love this modern one.
It's fun,
one.
Right? Yeah.
That's so cool.
Yeah, I do. Too.
Is that your favorite?
I do.
You do.
I do.
I do DIY.
I do. Yes.
Got it.
Can you
show
DIY?
I do DIY. And so this one card I want to show you. This was the one that stuck out to me that I thought would be extra fun because this is the craft paper type of feel on the outside, and then there's like a lace feel on the inside with the tissue paper little flowers. And I love me some tissue paper.
Yes.
So I mean, you watch
really
any of my DIYs, you know I love the tissue paper.
Crepe paper is that? Was it crepe paper?
Paper
or
tissue
paper.
Paper. Oh, they're my jam.
Paper.
Yeah.
Wow.
They are my
she
jam.
Loves clay. She
clay.
Loves
oh.
Paper.
I snuck some
she,
clay into this
oh,
one.
How
what?
Did I know?
All right, show us how to make it.
I'd be surprised if you snuck some of those twinkly lights in.
You know what? I tried to sneak them into the dressing over here. Christmas corner next time.
Exactly.
Okay, so for this, you can get some paper just at the craft supply store that looks similar to the paper that we have on here. And then we talk about this a lot of times on the show is creating your own stencils. And that's what we have over here. You can just go onto the computer and pick out whatever font that's similar to the card that you want to, you know, have that cohesiveness with. And so we have an M. We thought this was Maria, Menopolis, or Mark. We covered all three of us.
Sure.
Parker.
Yes.
And Provenzano.
Oh, and Provenzano.
We covered all the bases here. And we just need a D and an okay, just I'm going to keep going.
Well, it's a baby D,
There you go. Just cut it off. Right. Okay, anyway, so the point is, just to show you guys, when we talk about this a lot, this is what we're talking about, is that you just cut it out like this with an X-Acto knife. This is what I cut out. And you can use either one, to be honest with you. So, and then use your pencil, and then just trace. Oops, trace. Here. Okay, keep going out of the lines, guys. And then, but this is what I have here.
Okay.
And then what you do is you take your X-Acto knife, and then you just do this.
Just cut.
Yeah, and you can take your time doing this because you want it to be perfect. And if there's any extra pencil marks, you can just go and just erase them.
Maria.
And then you have this.
You have it.
Then you have
that
there. And so I glued it onto the envelope here.
And if you have messed up, since you're putting these pretty flowers on there, you can
actually hide it. That's true, you actually can hide it.
You could.
And so this is just a piece of tissue paper here. And then to save time, I fold it into either thirds or quarters. And then what you do is you take
Why
your...
Why would you do that?
Because then you don't have to cut. It's, you get four in one cut.
Oh, look mass production,
at
huh?
Me always
And they're
thinking.
All exactly the
and
same.
And they're all exactly the same.
Yeah,
and
but
then,
nature's not that way. Not everything is nature.
Well, I will show you how to make it very nature-esque by taking this, and then these will make them all different.
Oh.
Yep. Do a little bit in the center with your, do a little pinch, and then just kind of twist.
So making little petals.
Yes, you make little petals. And then what I did for the little center, instead of doing, you can find little beads, but I wanted it to be exactly what I had on there. And I just happened to have some clay laying around my house.
Oh, imagine.
So I just took a little bit of the clay and just made a little, you just take a little bit like this, roll it in your hands, and you have the little like center. And then you put it in the oven and bake it. For 200, it's like 275 degrees for about 10, depending on which clay you use.
Okay.
And then I did find that the best way to...
Yes. Allow me.
The best way to add the center in was through some glue like this.
Well, you don't want to use hot glue because that'll burn your fingers.
Yeah, exactly. So you put a little dab in here, put the little clay that you've already baked on there. We have some done already over here. Let that dry. And then you just add them on to your little...
Nice.
I'll add one that's already dry.
Okay.
So then you just add it on. I do use a glue gun for this just because it's pretty easy after that.
And then you just add the flowers around.
That's really cute, Maria.
Isn't it fun?
How sweet.
It's very sweet and very, it shows the little extra effort.
And it also, because you know, when you get the cards for your wedding or for a big birthday or something, you save the cards, but you never save the envelope.
You're right. Yeah. You do. I have the cards from my wedding, from my grandparents.
Yeah.
Guess who?
Oh, I love it. Oh,
isn't that pretty?
That's adorable.
Wonderful.
Sort of
repurposing. Thank you so much.
I love a Hawaiian wedding.
I know.
By the way, love is in the air, and it is almost time for June wedding season, and we are sharing tips all next month to make sure the big day is extra special for you. Well, whether you're the bride, maybe you're the guest, a parent, the happy couple.
Anybody.
Absolutely anybody.
Also, starting June 2nd, Hallmark Channel is premiering 4 new original wedding-filled movies. All you have to do is check out hallmarkchannel.com for all the info.